To episode 77 here at Beautiful Behind the Bunker Studios. My name is Todd Ansich, guys. I am your host for this evening, and with me, as always, is Josh Subrick.
Good evening.
How are you, Josh?
Fantastic.
You're very
Todd, thank you for asking. Yes.
We also have Joe Kimson from Flaggers Paintball.
Greetings. How are you?
And 17-year-old Parker Schnabel.
18-year-old
Parker
Schnabel.
It's
true. 18.
Migrating from the couch all the way up to the big boy chair up here and taking Gavin's spot.
It was a hard move, really.
Tough.
For sure.
You're lighter.
And Gavin's off tonight, so he'll be back in the next week or two. But we still have a interesting topic for What's Up With That tonight. So Ooh. Stay tuned. We have tons of things to get to on the show. Shortly, we're going to talk to a member of Houston Heat. Houston Heat, as you know, won PSP this past weekend at OXCC, so we're going to talk to him about that and his experience, as well as the new Spire Loader he has an opportunity to play with. He was one of the prototype testers of it, so curious to find a little more information about that. So yeah, we want to wish Houston Heat or congratulate them for their win on the weekend. Here's a pic from last week that we saw on Facebook that I snagged up. This is a picture of a family in from Mad Frog Paintball who were actually watching the show, and they make it a family affair. They put two computers up and spend the evening watching the show. So guys, if you get a chance to take a snap of what your behind the bunker viewing area looks like.
Hold on. Turn it up.
I'm trying.
Okay. Sorry. Go ahead, Todd.
Now, speaking of Josh, we were talking the last couple weeks, you have a new call sign. H has got his H. Right, HK Army.
Yeah.
And you've got your...
Don't be a square, man.
Now, this picture is a gentleman who sent this in. This is his thing of BTB, behind the bunker.
Is that...
What do you think of that?
Look at that.
Is that for our gang signs
but
when
what's
we're
with the
rapping
FX?
On the street?
That is actually one of Skeletor's illegitimate children.
Oh.
So
that explains a lot.
I can see the family resemblance.
Yeah, very nice. And Miranda, CJ Miranda from last week, we were talking about... launchers, slingshot launchers,
yes,
right?
Yes.
She wanted to know if this would be legal. So I don't know. Could that would go beyond ramping? I think
seems,
wouldn't it?
Seems more of a paint caddy, if you ask me.
That's nice. How they transport it from the factory. In big kit on forklifts, just big.
Yes, on the higher end models for sure.
Things.
Now, guys, stay tuned tonight. We are going to give away an awesome behind the bunker Murdertron designed T-shirt. You can see that right there. This is awesome. I have one of them myself. We've given a handful away. And any of you guys that are watching tonight, we're going to give away one live to you guys. So as the show goes on, I will have a trivia question for you. So do pay attention, and we'll get that going shortly. The topic of conversation for tonight is, if you could play paintball with somebody, either dead or alive, celebrity or otherwise, who would you want to play paintball with? We've had lots of people sending us in contributions. If you want to get your answer on the air, all you need to do is post it on the forum or put it on our Facebook page, and we'll get that on the air tonight. Why don't we start tonight with Colonel Mustard sent one in. Let's find out what he had to say.
Hey guys, Colonel Mustard here. Today's topic is, what person from history would you like to play against? Mine is actually from the area that I'm from. It'd be Daniel Boone. I think that he would probably be hell on wheels on a paintball field, because he was a hunter, a trapper, and fought in a couple of wars. there is a lot of stuff about him out there that isn't actually true as far as how amazing he was. But still, I'd have to believe that with the way that the world was back then, he had to be pretty dang good with a gun. I'd have to say Daniel Boone, bring it on if I had the opportunity. So, that's my answer, guys. What's up, guys? Colonel Mustard here. I'm standing here with...
My name is Matt Sossman. I play for Omaha Vicious in the professional division of the PSP. Recently, I learned about a guy named Willie that is an avid paintball player at Black River Paintball in North Carolina. He was supposed to come home, but 3 to 5 days before his departure to come home, he was injured by an IED, and he is actually back in the States now doing rehabilitation. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to raise enough money for him and his family to be together as much as possible.
For you guys to participate in the raffle, it's $5 a ticket and $10 for three. The drawing will be held on August 25th at Black River Paintball, and if you're purchasing your tickets online, you have until August 24th at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And Matt's raffling off of a Vicious jersey. Let's check it out.
This is the front of it. It's a Desert Camo UWL jersey. And on the back, we have the nice Vicious cross with all nine players' signatures. And one more thing is you do not have to be present at the game to win the jersey. If you come through online, I'll write your name on a ticket and put you in the bucket.
Easiest way to find this raffle online is to click the link that's at the bottom of this YouTube video. If you're watching this on Facebook or somewhere else that it was linked, just click on it and tell it to go to YouTube, and then look down in the comments, and you just click that link. It'll take you to a Facebook event that is this raffle, and you can send some money in.
Thanks, guys. Everything's appreciated. The family's really going to like it.
Thanks, guys.
From H&H Paintball, you're watching Behind the Bunker. Very cool. Guys, I like those videos. If you get an opportunity to make yourself one, send it in to showatbehindthebunker.com and maybe you can get on the show. That was quick and simple. Just grab a camera and send it over. Now, the Spire guys, we've been hearing all kinds of talk about the new Spire logo from Virtue. They had them, I don't know if they were for sale at MAO, I'll have to find out for sure, but I do know that they were there on display for sure. We had a chance to talk to Nick Swoliak last week, and he, about a week ago, and he had one as a prototype that we took a video of. Now, I posted it on our YouTube channel, but in case you haven't had a chance to see it, here it is, it's real quick. And then when we come back, we'll see if we can't get Nick live here on the show.
Hey guys, Todd Anson from Behind the Bunker. I'm here at my local event at my field here, and I ran into my friend Nick Swoliak, who you saw on the show a couple weeks ago. Hey guys, we have something fancy. Take a look at this. This is the new prototype of the new Virtue Spire. What do you think, Nick?
Well, it's a great loader. I've been lucky enough to be able to use this loader for the last 2 weeks. Some key things you'll notice is just the sleek lines up front. I'll show you the speed feed here. It's a prototype. I'm not sure exactly if it'll be the finished product, but works really well, so if you want to use a lid, interchange that. Really easy to take apart. Push this back button in. You see the back comes off. And the next step then, this little tab in here. Push that down, and the whole tray comes right out of the gun. All you have left is an empty shell, so this gets dirty as mine is from playing at this awesome field.
Sometimes I feel like an empty shell, so I can associate with this product.
Takes three AA batteries. The Spire, which many of you have seen online, comes right off, so you can interchange it. It's really soft paddles. This loader is, say, it's a fantastic loader. I mean, it hasn't jammed. We've done a couple tests with it, with leaving it out in the sun with a whole bunch of paint in it so the paint gets soft. No jamming issues. Loader turns on, spins just like that. Works off vibration, so the faster you shoot, it'll feel the gun shoot and it'll feed faster. This loader works really well, man. I mean,
now you've had a chance to play with it all this weekend.
Yes, I played with it all last weekend at the Michigan Monster Game at Hell Survivors. I played with this whole weekend here at your wonderful field for event three for the CXBL. I used it also the week I first got it, just doing tests at our warehouse at GI Sports in Chicago.
So you put at least a few cases of paint through it for sure, if not.
Oh yeah, Houston Heat, we just had a practice. We shot 140 cases in 3 days, so that's 14 cases a player that averages out to. So I'd say
quite a few paintballs through it. Cool. Yeah. Now, when we're filming this video, guys, this product has not been released. We are waiting to get permission on it. MAO is this upcoming weekend. We're hoping that it'll be released then. But as soon as that the product's released, you'll see this video on the show. So, guys, check it out. This is the new Virtue Spire.
And definitely tune in to Virtue. They can do a lot better job describing their loader, their product, than I can. Again, I don't know too much about it. You know, I mean, I know the basics of turning it on, turning it off, how to change the batteries and pull everything out, should I break paint in it. But I've had no issues whatsoever. I mean, the loader feeds great, keeps up with any gun. You know, their whole thing is speed isn't an issue because no one out there is really shooting a billion balls a second.
And now you got less time having to fix a broken hopper, so what are you going to do on Monday nights when you're free?
Come hang out with you and watch Behind the Bunker!
Woo! Check it out, guys. Hey guys, Todd from Behind the Bunker. So I just got sent this out. This is the new latest and greatest gun that's just been released. This is the new JT Splatmaster. Check this out. Lighter than any of your tournament guns out there. This is designed to get younger kids into the sport. This will still shoot up to 100 feet. They're saying on the box that it'll shoot 50 feet accurately. So we're going to give that a shot. What I'm going to do is I'm going to open this up and we're going to take it, put it over the crony. I'm very curious to see what it actually shoots out of the box. So no air needed, it's all spring actuated, so you don't need to have CO2 or high pressure air. In fact, it'd probably blow up the gun. But why don't we load this thing up and see what it does with the crony.
128. Let's see the consistency. 125. So the consistency's there. 147. That's the highest we've been able to get this to. So 133. So, put my safety back on, put my gun back down.
So it's still fairly safe. I think for a youngster, this is a velocity that you can definitely, definitely be safe with. You definitely still want to use goggles. Maybe what I'll do is I will see if I can shoot some targets out on the main field, see how far it goes. And I have a volunteer who says that it'll let me shoot him. So we'll see how this feels. Who wants to go first?
I'm having fun. All right, guys, come over here for a second.
Oh, I got one on the bone.
I tried to hit you in the tender spots. How did that feel?
Yeah, I mean, it kind of hurt.
Kind of hurt the compared to paintball? How much would that hurt?
Not as much as an actual paintball.
Okay, so these two guys, I picked the wimpiest kids in the entire town, and they're saying it's not that bad. So if you're a 7 or 8 year old and even 9 year old kid, I think this is probably okay. Would you guys be able to get hit with that again?
Yeah.
There you go. So check it out, guys. JT Splatmaster. If you know somebody who wants to get into the sport and try it out, I'd highly recommend that. That's pretty cool.
Okay, so guys, we are back. The JT guys, that's a neat gun. We had a lot of fun, and poor kids, I don't know if they really enjoyed the fact that we were shooting them, but good for them. Good for them for being
it's
good
character
sports.
Building. That's true.
Now, in the studio via Skype, we have Nick Slowiak from Houston Heat. Nick, are you with us?
Yes, I'm with you.
Ah, I see you. There you are, in your fancy Imperial t-shirt.
Oh, yes, quite right.
Yes, and Joe wanted to congratulate you on the job well done this past weekend.
I did, indeed.
Oh, thank you.
Yes. Yay. Very good. How was the event in general, to be honest with you? I was really trying to get to it, mainly because it was at OXCC, and I knew it would be a good event, but how was it overall?
Oh, I was going to say it was a great event. I mean, they did a great job, OXCC, Rick and his crew, and Gizmo. They did a great job preparing the field for the PSP. And the PSP, all the guys behind the scenes there themselves do a really good job setting the field up. So it was nice. I mean, I'd heard some good things about the field, and going there and seeing the layout and the setup was fun. It was exciting. It was a really great event. A little bit of rain Friday morning, but I mean, what would paintball be like without some inclement weather?
Well, yeah. When was the last time PSP had perfect weather?
I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't.
Yeah. But yet speedball teams won't practice in the rain. I don't get that.
sign me up for one of those teams.
For sure.
That'd be nice.
So the Spire, you had an opportunity to play with it all this weekend. I know you've had it for a while.
Yep.
And now that's a different one than the one you showed us in the video.
Is that a production model, that one?
Yeah. They gave me the only thing that we switched out, and I showed you this when I met with you last week at the field, was just the speed feed here.
Yes, sir.
They're still playing around with a prototype one, but otherwise, this is the one they took right out of a box, right off the back of their truck, and gave it to me. All we did is switch out the speed feed. I'm just testing out this new one for them. We're working with it. But yeah, it's the same loader that anyone would get if they were to order one.
Cool. So no difference. It still performed like it should.
I mean, no difference at all. They performed just like it should. I mean, there was a lot of talk about us changing out loaders, but that was Friday morning when it was pouring out rain, and none of us really put a lid on it just because we're not used to putting lids on it. And you know how funny it looks when someone goes to load a pod into a loader when they have a lid on it and they totally forget about it. So, I mean, it got a little wet on Friday morning, and that caused issues just with the paint. But, I mean, the loader were great. A lot of the guys on the team used them, and there were no issues, no jamming, fed perfectly fine.
Cool.
Yeah.
Now, you guys, you had said that they were for sale at MAO. That was a question that we asked on air before. Now, what were they selling for? Did they manage to sell any?
I went in there Sunday about 45 minutes before a finals match against Infamous, and they had four loaders left. When I met up with Mike and Chris, the guys from Virtue, they had a whole trailer, just boxes full of Spires. So, I don't know the exact number, but I'm pretty sure they sold out, almost completely out of the loaders. I believe they're going for $185, and then depending on the kind of speed feed you want, should you want one, it'll cost you a little bit more. I'm not 100% sure on how much that is with that total, but $185 for the loader with a regular lid. I don't have one of those. I just have the speed feed.
Now, as far as the speed feed is concerned, is it proprietary to that loader, or does it fit similar loaders?
It would just be for this loader. I mean, it's a completely new loader itself. It's similar to some of the Virtue speed feeds that you could find for the rotor, the Z2, just the way it's just with its layout, I guess you'd say.
Yep.
But the lid's pretty big, so it's definitely unique.
For sure. Now, Houston Heat, Infamous, the final game. That was that was a good game.
Yeah, it was. Yeah. We won. I lost.
Now, tell me about something. I see a picture floating around on Facebook.
Uh-oh.
Oh, you have a studio audience, I hear.
Yeah.
Now, this picture I see that's floating around, from MAO, you guys had six players on the field. What happened there? I got to be honest with you, I missed that game, and I'm just wondering what the propaganda is behind that.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay. I don't have
a picture. I think Aftershock at one point had six players.
Nah, I believe it was a Houston Heat image, and they label it off. I'll have to load it up before the end of the show to show people, but maybe you guys just started with one extra body on the field, that's all.
I don't think we did.
Well, you know what, Nick? Anything that gets you to win the game, like, I mean, good for you. You guys won the event. And, you know, whatever it takes, right? So.
Definitely.
All right, good. Well, thanks for calling the show tonight. I appreciate it. It's always nice to have you on. And,
anytime.
Good luck again. When are we going to see you next on the field?
World Cup,
I guess.
Nicholas?
Actually, you'll see me at World Cup, but if you guys are going to be at CXBL Richmond Cup, you guys be heading up there to Ottawa at all?
Oh,
maybe.
Yeah,
to the nation's capital? So,
yes.
Yep.
Yes.
Yeah, your nation's capital.
Our nation's capital.
Toronto?
For sure. Well, good stuff.
Yeah, I'll see you guys up there.
Absolutely. Well, thanks for calling again, Nick. We're going to move on with the show. We got tons more guys to get to. So again, Nick, congratulations on your victory this weekend, and good luck next event.
Thank you. Thank you very much, guys.
See you, buddy.
See you, Nick.
Bye-bye, Joseph.
See, he's learning his Russian.
He's speaking good Russian, yeah.
Very nice. So, guys, we are going to give away a Murdertron t-shirt just as soon as we get back. We're going to give you guys the trivia question. But tonight we're still talking about who in the whole history of the world, dead or alive, would you like to play paintball with if you had given the opportunity? So why don't we find out from Chase, the traffic cam, and we'll be right back, guys.
Chase. How's it going, guys? This is Traffic from Team Sova and the Traffic Cam. You're watching Behind the Bunker, and this week the question is, which celebrity, alive or dead, would you play paintball with? Can't do William Shatner because it's already been done. So, I would have to go with Christopher Walken. I think he would be hilarious on the paintball field. Just one of the refs says, you're hit, Christopher Walken, you're hit. And he'd be like, ref, you try and call me out again, and I'll stab you in the face with a soldering iron. I mean, it would just be completely hilarious to play with Christopher Walken, and that's who I choose. All right, I'm Traffic from Team Sova, and Traffic Cam, you're watching Behind the Bunker. Y'all have a good day.
Oh, yeah, you can believe your eyes. You're watching Behind the Bunker. Woo!
All right. That was great.
It was in ghost mode. Did you see
that? Skeletons.
Now, what did you think of his Christopher Walken there, Christopher Walken?
Well, I thought it was pretty bad. I'm not going to do my imitation because he's sick, and I wouldn't want to put him to shame while he's trying to get better.
I think...
That's classy.
I know.
I noticed on Facebook, which is on the internet, you can find it.
They have the internet on computers now?
They do it, indeed. Chase Traffic Morris stated or made a revelation that he was single. So any girl worldwide... What? Could have a chance at him. I think you need to submit a resume, a little synopsis about yourself.
You could post up his eHarmony.
eHarmony, yes.
Christian Singles, Plenty of Fish. I found him on all of them.
2012, Chase for the Chase.
Chase for the Chase.
Our new contest.
No monetary prize, though.
So, guys, why don't we give away a t-shirt tonight? I would like you guys to go over to Murdertron's Facebook page. And there's only two stipulations here. A, the right answer to the trivia question, and B, you must be a friend or you must like their page there. And before we get to that, guys, I want to tell you, if you don't win tonight and you want yourself a Behind the Bunker t-shirt, you can scroll to the bottom of the website right now and you'll see the support package. You can buy yourself Behind the Bunker t-shirt or barrel bag, all that sort of great stuff. And guys, that money goes directly to pay our internet connectivity. What are you looking at?
Someone said your mic is either off or muted.
Oh.
It's still there.
It's still there.
I still have it.
Sound guy.
Very good. So, guys, we're going to... The question for the show is, on the loader that Nick Slowiak was just showing us, what was the number on it? So, the right answer, guys, put it up there on the Facebook page, and you guys get an opportunity.
Was it 14?
It was not 14.
I think it was pi r squared.
So, guys, we have a new contributor to the show. This is Kyle King. He sent this video in. This is HK Booth at the MAO. This is Kyle King from Retribution Paintball. Check him out.
Hey, what up, boys? It's Mr. H here at the PSP MAO. Right now, you can check out our new speed feed. We have them for the Valkenizer Universal, which works for all loaders. The rotor, and we have the Z2 prop. These things are really amazing. They have the rain lid on them. It was raining out here yesterday, so a lot of people were picking that up. It helps out. Pops the pond and off really quick. And then you can also just use it like this. In case it's raining really hard, you never have to take it off. It works really, really well on this loader. And really well, same way on this, on the rotor. You can throw this on when it's raining, when you're going to load up, just take it off real quick. It works awesome. These things are doing really well. And we have them in different colorways here. You can check out all the other color options we have. But thanks for stopping by the booth behind the bunker.
If you would like to be a contributor to Behind the Bunker, all you need to do is send me an email to show at behindthebunker.com. I can chat with you about it. We're looking for videos 1 to 2 minutes in length, preferably 1 minute in length, of some good content. And if you have it, send it in. We'll definitely get it on the air. So any of you guys, Joe, what do you think? If you were to play paintball with someone, you had an opportunity to play with one person.
I was thinking that standing on top of a windswept hill in my camouflage, and if Marilyn Monroe was standing beside me, armed with her favorite paintball gun, yet she was wearing her white dress blowing up, it would be quite quite a sight, and it would detract and it would add to the flair of a paintball game. So I would say Marilyn Monroe.
It would look awesome on your Facebook profile.
It would. So there you go.
Instagram.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes.
You get Instagram at Retro.
Put a different filter on it.
Absolutely. Well, you know what? Why don't we check out Snarky from Johannesburg? Why don't we see what he has to say?
Arnold Schwarzenegger is arguably the most influential action star of the 1980s. And if Arnold Schwarzenegger played paintball, maybe we wouldn't have seen so much of this nonsense!
All right, so well done, Mr. Snarky. Dar.
Yes.
Yes.
Parker.
Who? Parker, yes.
Parker. Parker Schnabel. 18-year-old Parker Schnabel. What are you thinking?
Well, I would have to pick my father, because unfortunately he died before I ever got to play with him. And growing up in an Islamic household, he would always hit me around. And that was really my only option of getting back at him, was playing a full contact sport. So probably my dad. And if not him, Ryan Gosling, because he's so dreamy.
Oh.
Nice. But how would you gaze into his eyes with tinted lenses?
I wouldn't. I'd shoot him in the face.
Todd, can I ask you a question?
Yes.
The same question I asked before the show started.
Sure.
Why is Dar up here?
Dar's not up here.
Why is Parker Schnabel here? My knife got wet today.
Why don't we move on, guys? We're going to go to A-Train's video. This is A-Train from Track 21. Doing a kind of interview with our friend Skeletor at Ion Games. So check it out, guys.
I got my
Gagnon here. You're watching Track 21 with A-Train. Fantastic. You see friends everywhere you go. Skeletor, A-Train. 262. Yeah. You came here last minute, man. Our friend Barney made this happen for you.
Yep.
It's outstanding. Now, you've been to all the games. You've been to the top, the bottom, the panhandles, the murder mitten, What do you think of Skirmish?
Huge. Absolutely huge. Unbelievable. The amount of people. Unbelievable.
Well, that's awesome. And you've got the camera out for the Cat Shack reports.
Correct. Yep.
And you're writing for them now. Congratulations on the new job. And let's see what else has got. Skeletor 262 has got some great things going on. The YouTube.
Got a little giveaway. Got the V-Max loader giveaway.
So Falcon's doing that with you.
Correct.
Awesome. So make sure to subscribe, and we'll put that link right here. So I run or I fight and I crawl or I scream. Alright, well, I won't keep you because I know really busy, but I wanted you to critique something, okay?
Alright. Yep,
I've been working. There's the new kinder, gentler train out there.
Nice.
And I wanted to give something back, so I've been working with my friends, Skeletor style, to do behind the bunker segments and get that chain on slam. So if it's okay, we'll check it out.
I would love to see it. Alright. What you got?
These are my boys from TZB. And you're watching Behind the Bunker.
Captain America sleeps in Superman pajamas. This is Chris Hazard for Behind the Bunker. Check this out.
Hi, welcome back to Custom Corner. I'm Joe, and people have sent in lots of submissions this week, and here we go with the first one. It is the Triclops from Area 51 in Michigan. It was built by the Area 51 paintball owner, John Buland. It consists of three Tippmann Model 98s that are mounted on a frame and actuated by autococker pneumatics. One trigger pulls and fires all three guns simultaneously. At the bottom is a Tippmann Ordnance TM203. It was donated by John from Tippmann because they'd never seen a gun like this before. Good for you, John Rambo. I like that. Our next one comes to us from Josh Medlin from the Medellin Cartel in Colombia. He talked to you guys on Facebook. This is his JTER pump. He added a Hitman mod and took a Brass Eagle Stingray feed elbow for his hopper. Wow. His next plan is to add a remote line or figure something else. What a great setup this guy has. You know that you can't get parts for them. These are disposable. Next one, moving right along. This comes to us from Michael Breenengruben. And it's an SA-17 modded out with some behind the bunker stickers. It's like a tactical limited edition. He must be a fan.
He bought a support package.
Support package. Oh,
thank you.
That's nice. Thank you.
Come order again. In.
Move along. Next image, please. This is from Mad Frog. There's three pictures of his unhappy Mad Frog. He's obviously a comic book fan. And it looks like a custom crossfire tank, an axe, and an Empire Z2 loader that's been painted. Looks nice, very nice, and another tank. Very good.
Z2 loader.
Z2. Z2 is American way, Z2 is the Canadian way.
It's better.
This comes us from Clint from 300 Feet Percent. Yet another custom submission. This is from his collection. It's an Eclipse DC-1 Nexus Autococker with a Nebula Anno. It's got upgraded to an E2 board, ShockTech Delron Deton, so of course this custom Crossfire 300 FPS tank. Thanks to me for promoting this, and he'll have more next week, so please tune into Behind the Bunker, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Next, this is comes to us from Wes Shockley, I believe. It's his Nelson stock base gun with a feed tube, and he's also got a D68 kamikaze shooter. Very nice, and a 4-ounce tank, and looks like a Phantom. Very nicely done.
Ta-da.
More?
No.
Nope. No more.
I have that's a piece of no. paper. This comes to us from somebody that wanted to submit something, but we don't have it, so we won't look at it.
Oh. Check in next week. There's a teaser.
Guys, if you have anything that you customized in your paintball, draw a paintball marker or make us something out of Lego, like the JT guy. Just kidding. Guys, if you have anything that's customized, mask, hopper, paintball marker done in green ink that you can't see because it's contrast on my shirt, send it in to showupbehindthebunker.com for next week.
Very nice.
Zoomed in. Yeah. All right. Well, thank you very much for tuning in.
So, guys, getting back to today's topic, who would you play with if you had the opportunity, whether they're dead or alive, to play in history? Josh, do you have anybody?
Gunnery Sergeant Hartman.
Care to elaborate?
Gunny Hartman from Full Metal Jacket? No.
That's his name. What is his name? Harley Emery. Okay, I goddamn Harley guarantee Emery. It. You know what?
I'm talking about the actual character from the movie.
I have two Arlie Emery action figures actually talk when you push them. I'll bring them in next week. They have a drill instructor hat and everything. They're very cool. They're part of my action figure collection.
Very good. So if you guys want to get your thoughts on, you can either post it on our Facebook page, or you know what? We're going to take some Skype calls tonight near the end of the show.
Oh,
so get your Skype loaded up. We are Behind the Bunker, all one word, on Skype. And we'll try. Hopefully, we'll get some time to get you guys on. Why don't we zip on over now to WebDog. He sent his submission in. This is Tiger from WebDog, and we'll be right back.
Historical figures, huh? We're gonna get really cerebral with this one, aren't we?
I had to think about this one because there's a lot of people in the history of history who I wouldn't want to play paintball with. I just want to sit down and talk to.
For example, Sun Tzu, because I just want to sit down at the feet of the master and listen. Absorb all of the tactical information I can, because I know he didn't write all that stuff down.
But after thinking about it, I've narrowed it down to two people, and the first one is actually Daniel Boone.
You know, Daniel Boone, one of the original frontiersmen of North America, go west, young man, that whole thing. Actually, they didn't say that
that to Daniel Boone, did they?
But this is a guy who knew how to move through the woods silently. This is a guy who knew how to hunt in the woods. I don't want to play paintball against him because I know full well that he'd be able to sneak up on me wearing absolutely no camouflage at all. And I want to learn how to do that.
Now, some people are going to say, well, what about Davy Crockett? I mean, Davy Crockett was one of the king of the wild frontier. Yeah, that was good, except tactically speaking, the guy was an idiot. He allowed himself to die at the Alamo, which is just fundamentally stupid because you don't... Another video. There is a second possibility, and that's Julius Caesar. Yeah, good old Julie. The guy was brilliant as a tactician. He was a good fighter. He could make up tactics on the fly and make them work. These are things that paintball players do all the time, and I would love to watch him play and learn from him.
Not to mention, apparently he was just bloody hilarious. Vedi Vidi Vici was actually brilliant.
Although there are some historical figures who I would never, ever, ever want to see on a paintball field. Diogenes. I could just see him with that damn lamp in front of every tournament player, and he'd just be complaining the entire time.
Yeah, Google that. Yeah.
So, apparently Gavin's not here, so I'm doing the team feature this week.
Trying.
What's up with that?
Apparently.
What's up with that? So, our first teamer feature today is Lightning Force Paintball. Zuby, I'm talking, please.
These guys are from Tanawanda.
It's true. Formed in 1986, they played almost every type of paintball the sport has to offer, including speedball, scenario, hyperball, sup air, woods ball.
Taking a nap.
They're based out of Buffalo, New York, but have members all across the East Coast. They've played in 6 states and 2 countries throughout their long life as a team. Their home field is GRC in Angelica, New York. Cheesy peak. They've seen the sports ups and downs, but have always maintained one simple philosophy when playing: have fun. Even when they're playing highly competitively or a high-intensity game, the goal is always to have a blast. They've recently been sponsored by Empire Battle Tested, and are very excited at the opportunity they have to help build paintball.
Hold on a second.
Look at that.
I play on Lightning Force, although I haven't got my jersey yet.
You're making it more of a lightning farce. You should have stepped out of that and let them maintain their integrity.
Bazinga.
Anyway, they like to see new players enjoy paintball as much as they have and walk away with the spark and lifelong passion to play is extremely rewarding to them. They'd also like to welcome anybody who sees them at a game to come say hi. Their door to their camp is always open. And the future friends... You want to ding for that, too?
I should have said I played with Tracy Lords.
It's true. But, like you said, they have...
No, continue,
the Viking jerseys are very hard to miss, so they'd be more than happy to come talk to you. Our second team... Are we still in now?
We're in
the Dysfunctional Souls paintball team, started in Heyburn, Idaho, with members from all around the area. Just meeting up and enjoying the game of paintball on weekends.
Excuse me. What other towns are in the area of Hayden, Idaho?
I don't know. I'm not Siri, unfortunately. She doesn't work in Canada, remember?
She does.
Okay.
As of iOS 6.
Well, I haven't updated. You know what? Doesn't matter. As a team group, they started to host events at their local field, Breakpoint Paintball, which is now TC Paintball Heyburn in Idaho. The team also branched out into different states by going to Battlefield, Utah in 2011 and 12. As well as Hell's Assault in 2011. Most of our members use good Tippmann markers, customized to each individual's personal playing style, but have also branched out into speedball and are currently building a small team for local tournaments. They focus on fun and playing the game of paintball with safety as their main priority. They practice the mercy rule at their local fields and events and avoid scaring new players away from the sport.
Now, you said a small team. Is that with, people... Is there a height?
I would assume...
Is there an under-height restriction?
I would assume that it has to be... You have to be under 4 foot.
Well, we've already had a team of mimes, so it only makes sense.
It's a team of
little
people.
That's the next progression.
It could be a reality TV show.
Stay tuned next week.
They could hide behind the snake bunker.
Team small people. They could just sprint their butts off down behind a snake. Anyway, continue.
Next week, we actually have a team of bearded women, so... That'll be coming up next.
I bearded see Josh's what? Mom is making an appearance on the paint.
Bearded women.
Oh, bearded women. I think it's something else.
Yes. No, you get that at a seafood restaurant. So, guys, I want to send out a quick shout out. Clams. The
yes.
answer to that question.
Thank you.
I want to welcome
Cheese Peak.
Roscoe 66, Ripper, Phantom, Nicholas, Chris, Chris 17, Andy 6112. First Person Paint and Berserk for joining us for the first time on the show. We can see you guys on our chat forum. And if you're not watching us live, you should try it out every Monday night at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So yeah, definitely check us out, guys. And if you're watching us in Rewind, thank you for doing so. Joe, you have a press release.
I do. It's coming across the teletype. This is from the Empire BT Rangers giveaway. Two lucky people will walk away with some great prizes courtesy of the BT Rangers team, Empire Battle Tested, Canada's only pro-sponsored Woods Ball team in Canada from Empire. At the end of the Wasaga Beach paintball game, Scorpion's Lair, coming up on Saturday, August the 18th, this year's game will feature over 1,900 players. The Rangers will be giving away two prizes. First is an autographed Los Angeles Infamous player. This is the official Infamous jersey worn by veteran player Travis Lamontsky during the NPPL's victory in Chicago this past May. In addition, the other lucky winner will be taking home a brand, not an Empire BT Ranger, an Empire Prophecy Z or Z2 loader, depending on which side of the 48th parallel you're on. It's a manufacturer's list price of $169. This is one of the best loaders on the market. It would be an excellent upgrade to your gear collection. Or if you don't have a loader, it'd be a great start. I added that. All you need to do to win is to show up at Canada's largest game on Saturday. You'll visit their booth, answer the question, and the draw will be done at the end of the game. Empire Prophecy Z2, winners will be announced. They're also in the early stages. This is good for anyone wanting to be on a pro Woods Ball team, recruiting additional team members for the next season. If you feel that you might be interested in being a member of the BT Rangers, come by the tent. They also set aside a game for potential players is at Flag Raiders Phoenix Project on September 23rd. Act of Valor, it's Phoenix Project 27. So they're going to actually give you an opportunity to play with them on that game. And their team goal is to promote the sport of paintball, have fun at the same time. They'd like to play seriously, but they don't take themselves too seriously. If you feel that you want to be part of a team, the BT Rangers has a place for you. Come check it out. Check out the btrangerscanada.com. That was my press release.
Yeah. All right, time out. Could you just leave the chat in one spot?
Hey, easy there.
Quit messing around with it. Seriously.
Okay, guys, we're going to keep moving forward. We still got a ton to get to. Tonight's topic, again, is who would you play with if you had an opportunity to choose for anyone, both dead or alive, to play with.
Barbarella.
Let's move to Clint from 300 FPS, and right after that, we're going to go right into Cat Shack Reports, guys.
Hey everyone, this is Clint, 300 FPS. This week's topic is who's the person in history you'd most like to play paintball with. I sat out here, it's 110 today. I quit playing early. I think my brain's fried. I can't think of anybody. I can think of 20 people, I can think of nobody. I can't think of anything. But then I was sitting there thinking, while my brain was baking in the sun, and this is kind of a Gavin moment here, what's up with that? Why are paintballers so into three-letter acronyms? I mean, you've got HPA, HPR, LPR, IBG, ASA, BPS, FPS, AKA, AGD, WGP, ICD, the PSP, OMG. Then there's RPS, DXS, CPX, CEP, STO, the MAO, I don't know. Then there's QEVs, ANS, PBA, EMR, CCM, PBN, and SLP. I don't know. You're watching BTB. That's all for me.
Cool. Thanks, Mr. Clint. Chris. Our intern in the production booth.
Where is he?
Chris is doing sound tonight, guys. Dustin is off,
sound,
unfortunately.
Since minute one.
What is your thoughts?
If I could play paintball with anyone, fictional of course, I think I would play with Cleveland from Family Guy. Big fan of Spooner Street, and something just tells me that he'd be a really good paintball player. And he knows how to party over here.
Oh.
Something tells me Chris has been working on that.
I'm trying. And Professor actually got it for me, too.
Giggity.
Yes. Someone in the chat forum is saying Quagmire. Was there any other posts in the chat forum you wanted to show us?
No, I got yelled at for scrolling too fast.
Okay.
All right. Yes. I thought of someone else that would be interesting. Sorry for intervening.
Not at all.
Urkel from Planet of the Apes.
A little bit of strategy. Steve Urkel.
No, Urkel.
That's what that would be good.
Planet of the Apes. Just, you know, he's got some good strategy and stuff.
So high.
You know. Yeah. Anyway, continue. Yeah.
Or any one of the dudes from Act of Valor.
I have two. The first person I'd like to play with would be Enrico Palazzo.
Oh.
I don't know if anybody knows who Enrico Palazzo is, but for those that do, that's for you. Jason Bourne.
I'm going to Google this.
I would like to play with Jason Bourne because in those movies, he can't do anything wrong, and he can't get stabbed, he can't get shot. I'd like to see how he does on a paintball field, whether he does the matrix
just
around the paintballs coming at him.
I don't know,
it'd be an interesting...
Right, or Liam Neeson from Taken. Why don't we just say that then?
There's a new Taken
it's
coming
true.
Out.
They take his ex-wife
Taken 2.
Do you have a set of very special skills?
Yes.
Taken 2.
Well, why don't we take you to the next Cat Shack segment, guys, and we'll be right back. We still have lots more in the show tonight.
And with the Cat Shack Reports paintball news,
and I'm Chris Hazard, Canadian Honey Badger, Sisters Connection, Easy Creation.
We're back once again for Behind the Bunker, Monday, August the 13th, and another interesting week for paintball news. In the news this week, Tippmann did release their latest offerings, the FT12 flip-top marker, before it was available strictly as a rental marker for fields, and they've released it to the general public for sale now.
Really cool-looking marker.
I think it's a pretty good solid marker. I think it matches up to the Tippmann 98, and it'll be interesting to see how many people pick those things up as a marker of choice. Also in the news this week, the Cat Shack did release our full assessment of last weekend's CXBL Event 3 at Flag Raiders in Kitchener, Ontario. You guys were there.
Yes, we were. We watched... was it Tremblant, I think they were called?
Yeah, Tremblant Cowboys.
And also known as...
Well, they were the Houston Heat lineup.
Houston Heat lineup. Awesome. Super fun to watch. You learn a lot watching those events.
You really do. I know I get to see a lot of different things from my perspective, from a referee perspective, I guess, if you will. And it was super to meet all the Houston Heat guys.
Yep.
It'll be very interesting to see how it pans out. They are, of course, now on the road to the Richmond Cup in Ottawa and then on to the road to the next. So we'll see how that pans out. Keep an eye on that one. The Cat Shack did get our hands on a box of Hydrotech paintballs. This was a brand new release again that did take place not altogether long ago at Paintball Explosion in Illinois. What do you think about that Hydrotech stuff?
Well, I'd like to get my hands on it. Interesting to see. I mean, I can't really say much on it because, I watched Skeletor's video, and it was really interesting to see. But again, I want to get hands on it, feel it, shoot it. But it seems like pretty interesting stuff.
I think so, too. I'd be very interested to have a little bit of this stuff right here in front of me to look at and see for myself. Certainly, I do believe what I'm seeing courtesy of Skeletor 262. But again, you know, nothing's better than seeing it for yourself up front and close and personal. But there was our full assessment on the Cat Shack, and you could catch that on the Cat Shack reports. The Aaron's Army Insertion 1 event did take place just this past Saturday.
Mm-hmm.
You and I were both there.
We were both there, head to head.
The Tomcat set aside his cameras. We strapped on my old Tippmann Phenom.
Yep.
And we had at her.
A lot of fun. The turnout was pretty good. A lot of money raised. Despite the weather, it was raining pretty much all day. However, ballers are ballers, and they just went toe-to-toe against each other. We had a great, great fun day. No complaints at all. We're actually laughing, smiling, raining all over us. We had a great time. Tomcat and I went head-to-head a few times. He clipped me, but Mr. Dub Geek Revenge got me covered, so we're good.
I guess there's some video clips coming out.
Maybe. Depends.
I know I got a full article that's ready to come out on a little something that did happen.
Yeah, Tomcat snubbed us pretty nice. Stole our thunder. It was a pretty slick move, but Tomcat still got it.
If you're playing with the cat, expect the unexpected.
That's never going to happen again.
Well, no, not that one. Anyway, I guess that leads us to next weekend.
Sega Beach.
It's almost here. I did speak with Wasaga Beach just this past Friday, and I'm understanding that there are, as of right now, record numbers of pre-registrations. I anticipate this one to be the biggest historical game in Canada ever.
Over 2,000. Last year, we were just shy of 2,000, I believe. What was it, 1,900-something?
1,980, to be exact, is my understanding of what was in attendance last year, and I expect this to be well over 2,000 this year.
Well, it's going to be one heck of a game. If you're not there, you're going to miss out. Play with Tom, play with Citrus Connection, Devil Dogs, Alien Side, baby. That's where it's at. That's where all the fun's at.
I'm pumped. We'll see you guys at Wasaga.
Mm-hmm.
That's Tom, Tomcat Cunningham.
Chris Hazard, Canadian Honey Badger.
We'll see you guys on the field.
Peace.
Peace.
You know where we're going this ride!
It's the Hang of Bunker!
Yeah! Woo!
Welcome back to Paintball Around the World.
That's a squaw.
Squaw! Yes, it is. It's definitely a square.
I can't do
First up for tonight, Red Strike Blast Paintball, happening August 25th and 26th.
Where?
Blast Paintball.
Blast Camp Paintball.
Blast Camp, sorry. There's a camp in there. RPL South Africa, next event, August. No, it's not.
What's the next event? September.
September.
Mm-hmm.
Can they pay with Cougarans?
Jeez. Where have you been?
Of course
MPPL
they can.
MPPL D4 race. No, you can't paint Cougarans. It's not the currency in South Africa. It's Rands.
Oh.
You'd know that if you watched last episode.
Huh.
D4 race, Paintball Park, Pendleton, Illinois. Paintball Exposure.
I have some left over from when it used to be Cougarans.
Mm.
They're in the
OXCC, Battle of the Barrage, breakout from Beston, happening December 8th. In Chesapeake, Maryland.
Chesapeake?
Nice.
Exactly. Fold the Gap. November 9th through to 11th, the War That Never Was, just like the info on the poster. Five-man Woods Ball Tournament, September 9th, Swamp Paintball Park.
Where's that?
In a swamp, apparently. Friendship Cup, Ukraine, Kiev, September 8th and 9th.
In where?
Kiev.
Oh.
All of it?
HK Army is having their Street Ball Chicago at Paintball Explosion 18th and 19th of August.
That's this weekend.
Mm-hmm.
Holy smokes.
Pre-World Cup, September 8th and 9th, Area 51 Paintball.
In?
Area 51, just like this one. October 13th and 14th, it's no longer off limits.
Oh.
It's Area 51.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Next, Aliens in the Rockies.
In the attics.
In the attics, yeah. Well, same difference. Kind of like skeletons in the closet. September 14th and 15th, it's in Utah.
And this is an official Behind the Bunker sanctioned event.
Yes, because it has the Behind the Bunker logo on it.
Look at that.
We should have a sound we play for that, so everyone pays attention.
Oh, there we go.
You can ding it.
Fight Fire with Fire, the Guns for Hoses, October 6th, the Boston Paintball Park.
In Boston.
Boston, probably. Just couldn't take a guess on that one. September 1st, PEI Rec Zone, yet another Behind the Bunker sanctioned event. Breakout King of Crime, October 6th, happening at Swamp Paintball Park.
Where's that?
In the swamp.
Oh.
Waldo and Bomber Paintball, five-man woods ball tournament, September 1st. And that's in New York.
Where?
It's in America land.
America!
Paintugal! And this one, Joe, you pay in euros.
Nice.
September 29th and 30th.
Where?
Or sorry, Septembro, as it's said in Portuguese.
It's almost like Brazilian or Spanish.
Can you paint
a little bit, but yes. Just different. Paintball for Patriots, August 19th. It's to benefit Americans Vet Dogs.
There's a lot of calendar stuff.
Vulcan Feast is happening August 17th with Andy Porter and Ryan Sexton, who are barbecuing for the first 150 pre-veg people for the September or Super Game 44.
Where?
It's in the parking lot where the barbecue is. Weaver Soldiers 2, Battle of Ladrang, November 3rd in Mesquite, Nevada. And last but not least, Act of Valor, September 23rd at Flaggers Paintball. Join myself as I stomp Gavin to victory again.
Stomp Gavin to victory.
Yes.
Nice.
And we have three videos sent in for people who wanted to have their own little video for paintball around the world.
Their own 30 seconds of fame?
Yeah.
Hmm.
See if there's a Behind the Bunker logo in it.
Bunker?
Bunker.
Oh, yeah. Bunker.
Behind the Bunker.
I'm hungry and I'm out of.
Be sure to come join us at EMR Paintball Park on August 11th and 12th for our return of the quest for the Holy Grail. This game pits Goose of Team Lies and Deception commanding the crazy Knigets against Beaker of Team Exiled Souls leading the repressed peasants. This hilarious and fun hybrid scenario brings all the characters to life with the Frenchmen of Castle Arg, the Black Knight, Maidens of Castle Anthrax, the English Bobbies, and the ever ferocious Killer White Rabbit with his long, sharp
Jesus Christ!
I like Brazil.
Can I borrow that video? Please.
So, to continue on with Paintball Around the World, Chris, our intern, takes us to a new place every week. Chris, where are we going this evening on our journey around the world?
We're going to sunny Florida.
Nice.
I should probably turn my mic on, though. I think it's off.
I've been to sunny Florida before.
Yes, we are going to sunny Florida. There it is. Hurricane Paintball Park in Palm Bay, Florida is where we are going this week. It has reopened with Fillion Paintball and War Machine Paintball team running the field. Hurricane Paintball Park is a great place for any skill level of player. Whether you're a seasoned veteran or just want to have a birthday party with some friends, Hurricane is the place to go for paintball. The field features 14 acres of playing area with buildings, towers, and forts, as well as our all-city field featuring Castle Grayskull and the Hurricane Stables. Admission is similar, with walk-ons paying $10 plus $5 all-day air, and rental packages starting at $25.30 with 100 balls to start you out. They also offer a variety of snacks and two different lunch options, pizza or hot dogs. As always, if you're in the area, there's plenty of food nearby, and of course, you'll have no problem finding a place to crash. Beef O'Brady's gets top reviews from the local as a cool place to hang out in the evening. As for where to stay, the Quality Inn is your best value, with a room available for under $60 a night. However, if above par cleanliness is important to you, the Holiday Inn Express is a great balance for about $20 more. Whether you're planning a birthday party, corporate event, church outing, bachelor party, or just a day out looking for something fun to do, Hurricane is where it's at.
Well, that's awesome.
It's almost like Hurricane Paintball is a sponsor.
Hey, almost,
the way
right?
That was read.
That was really well done. I like that. That's awesome.
The criticism last week was more details in the surrounding area, so we tried to fill in as much as possible.
Is there any ice cream parlors close to the...
No. If you pay someone extra, I'm sure they'll truck one.
I like your restaurant and your hotel options.
Yes.
Actually, suppose I was trailering down. Would there be a trailer park nearby?
You know what?
And what sort of services do they offer?
I'll have to add those in for next week.
Is it full service trailer park?
No.
Because I know that I can stay at the Walmart.
That's true, you can.
But is there a Walmart in town? We should know some and shop.
You guys are asking for too much in
a Target.
A Target. Anyway, sorry, we'll move along.
No problem.
Yes.
Very good. So Gavin's not here tonight.
Where is he?
So we are still going to do What's Up With That.
What's Up With That? Probably hard at work at Terratech Industries.
Because someone has sent in a video, so why don't we go right to that and we'll see what's up.
Okay, nuts.
For 10-inch rifle TPX barrel. Boy, oh boy, do I have a product to snark at today. This thing is very expensive. $75 United States. I'd buy it again if it was $75 Zimbabwe. Let's take a look at the RAP4 website and see the photos. Okay, the photo shows it being used stock with no remote line. But let's look to the top of the page just to be sure. Nope, no description. So I can safely assume that this product can be used without any issues on the gun. You can see our stagehand holding it and simulating shooting through three magazines and moving on to a CO2 change. So here it is, on the gun. After all, it's important that when using a new aftermarket product, we can still operate the gun the way it's supposed to operate. Hey, what the is going on? You can't get the CO2 plug out. This stupid barrel shroud is in the way. This means you gotta either remove the barrel shroud or remove the barrel just to change the CO2. To quote angry video game nerd, what were they thinking? RAP4? Why did you design a $75 barrel like this? Why not design it so that maybe the shroud just slides forward and comes off easy? Or maybe has a cutaway section that's easy to remove? Something else! As it is now, you can't take the CO2 plug off. What's up with that?
All right, so Gavin's not here, but we will take it away.
That's very good, Snarky.
Yeah, if you have a beef or something that grinds your gears, as Gavin says, send it in to showupbehindthebunker.com and we'll discuss it on the air. Now, with that, I mean, obviously, yes, if you had a remote coil, that would work, but he's right. If it doesn't state that you'd require one, that's a pretty difficult one. How do you play paintball with only having the ability to have 112?
Maybe it was lost in translation. Ah, almost like Kimson, you're very smart.
So take warning. If I was him, I'd probably send the company an email and maybe they'll do a refund or get you set up for free an adapter kit to have your remote coil put on. All right, there's got to be some.
Cut the end of your barrel off. I mean, the end of the gun off. And then you
could
just...
You could DatOps custom something, I'm fairly sure.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so guys, send us in your... beefs to show at behindthebunker.com. Now we have another video to get to. This is one of our final contributors for the topic that we're discussing tonight. Now next week we're going to be talking about is paintball or is speedball and scenario that much of a difference of a sport? You know, so when people are referring to paintball, are they referring to both? Should we categorize speedball and scenario ball as different? So send in your thoughts and suggestions next week or videos and we'll get you guys on the air. So why don't we take a quick commercial break and we'll be right back with our next contributor, which is Wolf. Hoo-yah.
Oh.
Warden, you're watching The Wolf's Den. Hoo-yah!
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this edition of Behind the Bunker. My name is Wolf, or Traveling Wolf. I'd like to say, please do not try videotaping and driving unless you have the proper equipment. I do it very safely. I have a car mount for my camera. It's made specifically to fit into the car and hold steady and strong. I've got a remote control to start the camera's filming. It's no different for me than using a hands-free phone kit, which is some else I do have in the car. But I'll try not to use both at once. Our topic today is who would you most love to play with, alive or dead, celebrity or whatnot? Very cool question. I've got two answers for that. My first one being, I think it'd be amazingly cool to be able to play with one of the Navy SEAL teams. To play with one of the teams and be able to, you know, get actual helicopter inserts and be able to use, you know, some cool Humvees or whatnot for insertions and, you know, get that real effect going and to be able to play with some of the best strategic operators on the planet, I think that would be like literally a dream come true. I mean, could you imagine just following these guys or even playing against these guys if I had the right team with me to see if we could actually give them a challenge. You know, choose, you know, some crazy bush somewhere and just have at it in the forest for a full day. I mean, that would be outstanding. So yeah, SEAL team would be a dream of mine to play with or against, for obvious reasons. Number two on my list would be the POTUS, President of the United States of America. I'd love to be able to play with my hero Barack Obama and have his family out there and show them how much fun the sport is, how family-oriented the sport can be and how much of a hidden gem we have in the paintball world. I think that'd be very, very cool to hang out with him and the wife and the kids and shoot paintballs and have fun and keep politics out of it, just play with a hero. I mean, that would be outstanding. And I think that'd also be pretty cool for exposure to paintball itself. You know what I mean? So yeah, pretty simple, pretty basic, easy. Wolf versus the SEAL teams, or Wolf playing with or against the President of the United States of America. That's about it. Hope you enjoyed this quick and safely filmed episode of The Wolf Den on Behind the Bunker. And I hope to see some of you guys at one of the biggest games coming up in the next week. And I hope to also, if I'm lucky, I'm going to try and get out to the next Flag Raiders Phoenix Project game, which is, I believe, named after my new favorite movie, Act of Valor. For some reason, Joe and the guys literally always pick to have their games when I have the kids. So it totally conflicts with my schedule. So you never know. Maybe I'll be able to get Grandma to hang out with the Cubs or something. We'll figure it out. Thank you very much for watching this edition of The Wolf's Den. And I'm just here driving to another meeting and listening to my music. See you next time. Play safe. Keep your goggles on. And by the way, boom! Yeah, baby! How we doing? Yeah!
Wolf reminded me of something in that video. Somebody I'd absolutely love to play paintball with, and that's the guys from Top Gear, because nobody's funnier than those guys.
Which one?
The British one, not the cheesy, fake, garbagey American one.
I thought you meant the Super Nintendo video game.
Yes.
No.
So guys, we were giving away a Murdertron t-shirt this evening. The gentleman that won that had the correct answer of 24, and his name, Chris, was Nick White. Am I correct on saying that?
You
are. So congratulations, Nick. Can you get a hold of me through Facebook, and we will send you guys out a Murdertron t-shirt. Now, guys, Behind the Bunker is trying to get out to as many events as we possibly can this year, and we're using ourselves as well as our correspondents out there to spread the word and get our stickers out and our swag. So coming up next weekend, 18th and 19th, you can find Skeletor at Paintball Explosion for the HK Army Street Ball. That weekend, you can also go to Midway Paintball for Scrims War, and you can see Clint there from 300 FPS. The following weekend, on the 25th and 26th, if you go to Blast Camp, which is the Viper's Red Strike, which you saw paintball around the world, Skeletor will be there as well. And if we go all the way up to June 9th, you can find Chase Traffic at the Woods Ball Tourney at Swamp in Gloucester, Virginia. So
A-Train will be at Blast Camp as well.
A-Train will be at Blast Camp as well. So guys, we're going to keep you abreast. What's
camp.
That?
He'll be at Ballast Camp.
According to his typo.
Is that the American?
So we're going to keep you abreast of guys over the next Russian couple camp. Weeks of where everybody's going to be.
Ballast Camp.
So if you want stickers, just head on over. So why don't we move on, guys? Skeletor 262 sent in a fantastic video. Hydrotech is a new paintball manufacturer on the market, and they're boasting a water-based, all-natural paintball. We've been hearing about that for a couple years now anyways. Now apparently they have it in production. Skeletor had been given a case of paint and put it through its paces. So why don't you check this out? He did a really good job on this.
Welcome to my research vessel, the Nautilus. We're here today checking out the Hydrotech Element Field Series paintballs. This eco-friendly H2O fill ball was extensively tested this afternoon. Let's check out some of the footage.
Hydrotech has been in development for years, taking their time and interested in feedback. Hydrotech is all about the environmentally friendly product. The shell is resistant to water and humidity, and has a 2-year shelf life. this ball can still be fired after hours of soaking in water. This plant-based shell has all the look and feel of plastic and can withstand a full cycle in the wash machine. Like this one. Other balls react with water within minutes. This Field Series paint has an almost lotion feel and smell, but its marking capabilities are virtually the same. The shell seemed to break on the seam many times, but also fissure as a regular paintball would. The fill marks well and cleans easily. Taste is better, but not recommended. Firing the paint through my Splatmaster was accurate, and the 2.8 gram ball is lighter and travels faster. At your gun's same settings, always rechrono and never intermix balls. However, my electronic gun knew just what to do with it. Being struck by the Hydrotech seemed to be typical of a paintball shot, in both its marking capabilities as well as the mark left by the round. When frozen, many balls cracked open at the seam, and the fill turned into ice cream. However, it can easily withstand 120 degrees Fahrenheit. The shell, on impact with a hard surface, mostly breaks apart. But even with over a week outside, the shell still seemed completely ineffective. We will keep an eye on Hydrotech.
Hydrotech! Wow, that was excellent! I hope you get a chance to check out the new Hydrotech Element paintballs, hopefully coming to a field near you!
All right, well done. Nice to see that Hydrotech is coming out with that paint. Hopefully that'll be on the market soon, and hopefully we'll be able to get a chance to see that. So tonight, guys, the conversation we've been talking about is if you had an opportunity to play with one person, whether they're dead or alive, and to play paintball with, who would you choose? Now, we have a Skype caller in named Brody. Mr. Brody, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good. Who would you play with?
The one and only, the Crocodile Hunter.
The Crocodile
Crikey. Hunter.
Crikey.
But not even like having him on the field, just narrating the game. Just be like, Crikey, he's in the snake. Or like, just like, as you're going up, just be like, now here's the moment. Here's the moment you've been waiting for. Oh, gorgeous, gorgeous. Oh, he's angry. He's angry.
Good for you. Well done, Mr. Brody. Call back anytime, sir. If anyone else would like to Skype in, get a hold of us. I think we had one more person here. One moment. Guys, just a reminder, our next week conversation is going to be, is paintball paintball?
The person whom you're trying to reach.
Apparently they're unavailable. is paintball paintball, or is speedball in scenario that much of a difference in the sport? Do we have you now? No, we do not. Okay, so guys, we still have phone lines are open. Call
operators are standing by.
If you pledge $13, PBS will send you a lovely Wrong Show. Yeah. PBS.
Let's try this again.
Sure.
Oh.
It's Amtrak.
It's Amtrak. How are you, sir?
Not too bad, man. What are you guys up to?
Good. It's track 21.
Doing a show.
How do you do it? Track 21?
21.
Very nice. Oh, let me move this guy out of the way. So what do you have to say?
It looked better before when it was over his face.
Aside from, obviously, the BTB panel up here, who would you play with?
Teddy Roosevelt.
Who?
Teddy Roosevelt. Teddy Roosevelt. And why would you say that?
He protected both our borders, and he was a fighter. That guy was like a legit American. He would never back down from a fight at all. And he would protect our northern border with me.
I also heard he wasn't allergic to whiskey.
Not at all. The guy with the beats, he was like the manliest of men. I just like to roll with him for a while. Commercial coming up.
I enjoy your shirt that you're wearing. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
That is a shirt that I got from slingpaint.com at last year's Pull the Gap. It's like a Facebook for paintball. So
yeah.
Check out slingpaint.com, and you can create your own paintball profile so you don't annoy all your other Facebook friends like I do.
Yeah,
with your paintball world.
For sure. Matt, the producer, is telling me I got to roll. We only have a couple minutes left on the show. So thank you, A-Train, for calling in.
No problem, man.
Thanks, dude. All right, guys, why don't we move over real quick to this week's section of the vault, and we'll be right back.
Hi there, welcome back to From the Vault. My name's Joe, I'm from Flaggeters Paintball, and you're watching Behind the Bunker. Anyway, guys, each week I do a segment called From the Vault. It takes us back in time. Anything that's old school has to do with paintball. I try to touch on it. This is most of my personal collection stuff that I have. Anyway, Flag Raiders used to, back in the day, we used to send out a newsletter annually, and we called it From the Bunker. Great name. A journal for today's modern adventure. Paintball games weren't called paintball games. In Canada, they were called adventure games. In the U.S., it was called Splatball. Thus, the name Tonawanda Splatshot and things like that. I can say it with an American accent, Tonawanda Splatshot. Anyway, so this is my January 1989 edition. Let's see what's new at Flag Raiders. We've got a tiger cage, fence around the U.S. base, new guns, Sheridan, PMI pistols, rifles which are more powerful and accurate than the Uzi, which is the Mark I Uzi we used to use, full coverage face shields, and some new bunkers. We're looking for some referees. The Adventure Hotline, still our phone number. Seasons passes, save $5, adventure cash. Wow, who knew BOGOs could be so popular? This is a 1989 Groupon. I sold the rights to Groupon. They came out with it. Just kidding. We had a scenario team back in the day. Our answering machine is available. The new velocity, as of April 1st, 1989, the new velocity for 68 caliber paint guns will be 300 feet per second. The new maximum velocity for 62 caliber paintballs will be 330 feet per second. That means we must have got a chronograph. For anyone that plays outlaw paintball, a chronograph measures the speed of the paintball leaving the barrel and determines its speed for safety. Anyway, we had one. Let's see what we have for changes. All PMI markers, guns, sorry, all field guns, PMI and rifles will be equipped with direct feed and 50 round ammo boxes. We were the first paintball field in Canada to go to direct feed and put hoppers on our guns. So that was pretty cool. I've got some new guns as well. Safety, individuals and small groups, litter to help clean up our field. We were green before green was a term. If you bring in 10 CO2s or 10 empty tubes, we'll give you a full one. Not bad. Good incentive to keep the bush clean. A new price list. We're looking for some referees. Our second annual big game, 1989, July 23rd. This predates the Phoenix Project, but we used to do big games before we did scenario games. Wayne Dalek was, as everybody knows, is the pioneer of scenario games. So we started doing scenario games, I think, in 1993 when we were writing our first one, watching O.J. Simpson being chased slowly down the highway in California in his white Bronco. Nice tone-on-tone contrast. Anyway, we've got some bulk gun purchases. The PGP you can get manufacturer's list in Canadian dollars back in the day was $279. The PMI 1 was $329. PMI 2 was $469. The 68 Magnum was $538, and the Assault, whatever that was $299. So as you can see, prices have come down dramatically since then as well. Here's the factory stock 68 Magnum, same base gun as the PMI 2, but it has a red dot sight, direct feed, comes standard, so it's pretty neat. Got some cartoons that you've seen somewhere, Rookie's Fatal Errors, a veteran would hide behind a big tree, and a rookie would hide behind a small tree. Those are sort of common errors. But anyway, guys, girls, this is our annual From the Bunker from the beginning of the 1989 season, so it's a 1988 publication. Anyway, you've been watching From the Vault. My name's Joe, and we'll see you next time.
All right. Well done, Joe. Next
Thank you.
Week, do you know what you're doing next week? Or
I do. I have an idea.
Ah, fantastic. Now, we have another Skype call in, guys, so if you want to get to us, we only have a couple more minutes, so do get us that show at our Behind the Bunker on Skype. Wes is joining us all the way from...
Wesley Snipes?
Omaha, Nebraska.
Omaha, Nebraska.
Home of the Cornhuskers.
You very nice. Cows. So, Wes, tell us, if you were to play with one person, who would that person be?
You know...
No, wait, that's why we're asking.
In 2002, a good friend of mine passed away, so if I could get one more game with Matt Luber, that would be awesome. But if not, second choice would be Derek Obataki of the Kamikaze Shooters, because I know they were good friends, and I never had the opportunity to meet Derek as many times as he came down to Hawaii, so that would be kind of cool.
So see, guys, there's a lesson. Get all your friends out now. Encourage them to play paintball so there's no regrets later. And go out and play paintball as often as you can so there's no regrets. So.
Right.
Very good. Awesome. Well, thank you for the call in, Wes. And
thank you.
Keep watching. Thanks, buddy. So, guys, all you need to do is get us at Behind the Bunker on Skype, and we will get you guys on the show. Anything that you guys want to promote before we go, Josh?
If you have any extra posters for paintball around the world, send them in to show at behindthebunker.com.
Oh. Good idea.
Include the Behind the Bunker logo.
Oh, Matt's on the ball tonight.
Yeah?
Not like Chris doing the sound tonight, but Matt's on the ball tonight. So
an hour and a half to get it right.
at least he's awake this week.
Very good. Hopefully Dustin's feeling better. We'll see him back next week as well as Jack. Jack started a new job. He's a
meter.
Yes, please come back.
So we'll see him hopefully next week as well. Jack, hopefully you'll be back next week. Joe, what about yourself? Do you need anything for next week's show?
If anyone has any things they've customized, modified, yes, like the President's Secret Service stuff or anything like that, send it into Custom Corner. Any markers, modifications, stuff like that, show it behind the bunker. I'll talk about it.
Parker
I'll mock
Schnabel
it. I'll try.
/Gavin. Well, Gavin, I know,
what's
would
up
like,
with that?
Would like, what's up with that? But Parker Schnabel, if you have any questions or anything you would like answered, feel free to send them over to us and we'll try
do stuff
our best
with
to answer
it.
Them on air. And I'm going to try this. Is it Behind the Bunker? Is that what we're doing? Is that what we're
Somehow
doing?
It has a this and a that and a this. I haven't been able to. Oh, there, look at that.
There you go.
I don't get it.
BTB, you know me.
Yes.
Parker.
Now, we have one person that's just joining us in the Skype again. This is Miranda. She only has a head. I'm sorry, CJ Miranda, I call you. CJ, but she only has a head, as you can clearly see by her Skype photo there.
She was born with headphones.
And using an Xbox headset.
And using an Xbox headset, but that's okay.
I like
it. So CJ, first of all, I want to say thank you for your submission of your slingshot today.
You're welcome.
And now if you were to play with one, very nice, Matt. Matt's on the ball.
So
if you, we're just sorting your brassiere while we're talking to you. Hopefully that doesn't make you nervous. No.
I'm not wearing it, so it's okay.
Right now? So if you were to play with one person in history, either dead or alive, who would you play with?
My dad. He was a PMI and a sharpshooter in the Marine Corps. He was a drill sergeant, too, but primary marksmanship instructor, and basically would, you know, instruct the snipers how to shoot. So I would play with him. I think he would be awesome at paintball, so I'd play with him.
For sure, for sure.
A little one-sided.
A little one-sided, yes.
Yes.
He'd be an expensive person to buy paintballs for if he's a sniper, wouldn't he?
No, because you confirm your shots.
That's right. That's right. All right. Well, listen, thank you for calling. We're nearly at the end of our show. See, guys, it is just that simple. All you need to do is get on Skype. And yes, that's not Miranda. That's her slingshot.
What's he doing?
I think he likes a certain pick over here.
He enjoys it.
So maybe we'll have one more look at that, Matt. There we go.
Fifth time.
I think it's false advertising.
It is false.
Those are 25 caliber paintballs.
You can clearly see the padding on it too, right?
Yeah.
The little pad. Okay. So guys, thank you very much for watching. My name is Todd Anstrich. I was your host this evening with Josh Shabrikas. Thank you for coming in. Joe Kimson from
yes.
Tigraders.
No, that was a wave. That wasn't a high.
Alaskan
that
was a Gold Rush.
Whoa.
As well as the two guys in our production booth. We had Matt the Crypt pushing buttons and Chris Christofferson tweaking sound today. So thank you guys very much for watching. We'll see you guys next week for episode 78.